Hello and welcome back. This is 00 Debbie and this is episode 21 of Agrarian Skies 2. As you can see behind me, I have finished the other set of platforms that I started. Woohoo! Alright. Yeah, that's awesome. I can also see that I have a nice big area to make my wildlife reserve over here. Oh yeah, it's gonna be awesome. I can't wait to get that going. Woo! So let's jump right in. I have a little bit of quests already set up for us to turn in and stuff. So let's get going. All right. I accidentally did combine one, but that didn't finish the quest off. It's this compacting drawer that we need here that finishes the quest off. So where was that at? Storage Wars. For the control your drawers. And that's going to get us a compacting drawer, but we already have one. Oh, wow. Excuse me for just 1 second. Seems I forgot to. I think it can be up to 20. It's okay. There we go. That's a little. Hopefully that'll be a little bit better. Okay. We do have one unclaimed quest. Where? I don't see it. Oh, that quest must have unlocked AE. I did do the one quest that was in there for the stone. For the sky high, you just put one of the sky stone dust into a barrel of lava and it gets you that. So that that quest right there just opened up this, because that was not there before. Awesome. And that is step one for making massive automated contraptions, quartz, and lots of it. So that requires a quartz, another quartz, and a charged quartz. Oh man, this is so awesome. I didn't realize that that one quest was what was holding it back. So, woohoo! We'll get a Certus Quartz cutting knife and a reward bag. Oh, man! Yes! Yes. That was definitely unexpected, but very welcome. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Can't wait now. How did it get dark already? Oh my goodness. All right, let's look at what's in the bag. A leadstone flux capacitor. I guess that's better than the tuberous flux capacitor, which I have two of those somewhere. Yeah, right there. But I do plan on... Oh, the one I got was just leadstone. I want to upgrade my jetpack because this one's getting, I don't know, it's a little bit difficult to maneuver around when I fly because I fall so fast. So, yeah. Anyway, we have a couple more quests that I already have, completed basically in our little areas over here, like this one for the block extenders. That's back up in Storage Wars. And that gets us a linker. Some of these mods I've never used with. Block extenders are placed on an inventory by sneaking and right-clicking. Once placed, it will put items, fluids, and energy into the connected inventory as long as it's compatible. There are several types of block extenders, the most basic of which Just puts items in the first available slots. Filtered extenders can set specific items as acceptable or not acceptable. Advanced block extenders can spread items across the inventory, set a stack size per slot, and specify which side to output to. The highest tier is the wireless block extender, which functions as an advanced filter extender from up to 16 blocks away. Extenders work with barrels, drawers, and chests. It sounds like pipes. Some type of pipes. Okay. Oh, look, that opened that quest and this quest. The Ender Tank's still, it's a little bit pricey. So we still have tons of quests to do in the power. Tons to do in the assembly. Oh, yes, and I did make some Ardite because I want to upgrade at least one of the picks. I'm not sure which, but I went ahead and made a couple of these guys up to get 4 Ardite. So that's another quest we can turn in. That way, I'm not sure which one I want to do, so I've been trying to level this guy up, but I'm only going to use this, I guess, in the Nether. The other pick is much, much better. I've got quite a bit of levels on it, and I can actually mine the Ardite with this, so I guess it would make sense to upgrade that one first. But I do have the materials, but what I don't know, I can't do that. I need the actual pick mold. But I think I'm going to upgrade this pick here. I'll do that off camera. But yeah, I smelted up some of the Ardite that I gathered up in the Nether. I might just, you know, in between this episode and next, because I've been doing a lot of this expanding, I might just go romp around in the Nether, maybe kill some of those mobs that I'm needing for the quest and whatnot. For the mob quest. We're still holed up here, but that's just because these are going to be really big, nasty chains of mutations. So yeah, let's go have another look at that applied engineering, because I've sort of been waiting for that. Waiting. Growing more quartz. To grow quartz, you will need seeds. Toss quartz dust in water to get the corresponding seeds. Throw charged certus, nether quartz, and redstone into water to get flux seeds. I don't think that's right. And I don't really have... Oh, I guess I do have a puddle of water down here. For the aqueous, I'd be kind of... it's not really... I'd be scared I'd lose them down there. And there's also one here. Same thing. Maybe I could just take some of this stone. Sort of knock off these fences. This is going to make a big old mess real quick. Yay, I'm making a mess. I just cleaned it up, so that's okay. That's okay. Maybe we can just do that. That way I don't have to just have random. And this part is sort of hidden, so I won't notice that that is different. It's different. Shh. Don't tell anybody it's different. Shh. Okay. So, what did it say again? We need to throw charged Certus, Nether Quartz, and Redstone. We don't... we have almost a stack of this. I'm still keeping an eye on this, because if I get something full, this is going to start backing up. So I just come over every once in a while and check and make sure everything's groovy and none of the inventories are getting backed up. So, but everything seems to be working just fine. I could probably use some more speed upgrades in this one as well. This one seems to be doing all right because it's only doing this one, and I have 4 speed upgrades in each of these. Whereas this one is outputting for basically the other side of all 3 of those. So I should make it 3 times faster than the other ones to keep up. But it seems to be doing all right. Yeah, it seems to be doing all right. So, I don't know. Let's get 8. 8 is a good round number, right? I put the quartz up here. One more. I put the quartz up there so I could, I did have several stacks of it, so I just put it in there. Just so it'll be accessible with the other materials. And I think that's what it said. Maybe I didn't do that right. Awesome, there we go. Okay, but this isn't seeds, it's flux crystals. That's what I thought. But we did get an achievement for the unnatural. Create flux crystals. But that said seeds. I guess in order to get the seeds, you have to have the flux crystal first in order to grind it down into the powder to get the flux seed. Because you have to combine that with sand. Okay, so let's get some sand. Let's just grab a whole stack. So we're gonna need some of this, some of that. Probably not that much. Let's do like 16 of it, just like this. So we'll have to go pound that stuff out. Just pound it. this will take it a minute. This will take a little minute, but... Okay. Maybe we should only do 8. Just in case I'm doing it the wrong way. Then we still have 8 more to work from. But those weren't bad since I've had that thing running for a while. I have quite a bit. And that, wow, that is fast. Get a little sip of coffee while we're waiting. Refreshing. And it's done. Awesome. Okay, now we combine the dust to get the seeds. Oh, yeah. And that doubles it. So that's kind of cool. There we go. We have seeds. Yes. And it's going to give us 16 more dust. Amazing. There's inscription, growth acceleration. I think that is something we want to do first, because growth acceleration is awesome. Okay. This says, place a crystal growth accelerator next to a water block that has an AE seed in it, and apply power to the top or bottom from ME cables. This will slowly purify the crystals. The charger can be used to power various tools. Crystal growth accelerator and a charger. Let's look at that. Crystal growth. What is this? Oh, that's AE2 stuff. Oh man, that looks awesome. Is that... Oh, I hope that's an automated version of this, because this is one of my least favorite parts of AE2, is having to throw the stuff on the ground. Uh-oh. One second. Okay. Sorry about that. Let's check this out. Is it good now? Okay. I know what the problem was. My hard drive got full and it just... Well, not really full, 3/4 of the way full, and it just doesn't like to record anymore. So I had to process a video to make more room. So yeah, I did a little bit of stuff while I was waiting. So I have to say something, and I went ahead and made another one of these resonant energy cells. So I could just have another one over there charging up now. This one should last us quite a while, and probably I will eventually switch this out with maybe a tesseract, so it'll just automatically get the power over here for us. I made the charger. That was a fairly easy recipe. Let's see, charger. Just two of those flux crystals with 5 iron. Easy peasy. And I made the growth accelerator. And it took 4 of the crystals. Once you make this charger here, because the holdup on the flux crystals is that you need charged Certus quartz, but once you get this charger, you can use it to charge your Certus quartz. And I think it's random how long it takes, because I've seen it go instantly or take like maybe 30 seconds or so. You can see that it has like little particle effects coming off it every once in a while. And it says on there that it's charged like that. Second line, it says Certus quartz crystal, and then when it is charged, it says charged. But you can make now as much of your quartz as you want into charged quartz. And that's what I did. I had enough. of the charged crystals down there to actually make it. I just didn't want to use up that much. I made another, I think 16 of the flux crystals, which made 32. So that gave me enough to go ahead and make another 5 of those growth chambers to make this crystal growth chamber, which is just awesome. It's so awesome. Let's just get that out. Okay, so you can charge your Certus quartz, and then okay, so we have 8 here. Let's go ahead and let me show you what I'm talking about. This is cool. As well as growing your seeds, it will also make you some flux crystals, like instantly. So you don't have to throw anything in water ever again once you get this. It's totally worth making right off the bat, because that is one of my least favorite parts about AE2, is throwing stuff in the water and waiting 10 bazillion years for it to do something. It doesn't process these as quick as the flux crystals, but it's still way quicker than sitting there watching it not grow in the water. So definitely worth getting this as soon as possible. This is awesome. Yes. I'm so excited about this. I'm speechless. I don't know what I can say to you to describe this. It is so amazing. Simply amazing. Because I really love AE. I have since it came out, but they changed it to where this part I didn't like in the AE with the throwing the stuff in the water, but this will bring one of my favorite mods back to me, and I love it. I would just give it a hug. Hug, hug, hug. Sorry, I'm being silly. That's okay, but let's go ahead and turn this in. It's going to give us a pure Certus quartz crystal. Excellent. Oh, this tells us to make the growth chamber. There you go. The crystal growth chamber will allow you to grow and purify crystals without the need for puddles. And we get a pure nether quartz crystal. So that's awesome. So now all we need to do is this inscription. Wonder how you make how you get these presses. The final things you need before you could get started in AE2 are inscriber presses and an inscriber. The presses can be gotten by sieving various metal blocks. Sieving metal blocks. So let's look for the calculation press, and we'll get the engineering press. I think that one's diamond, and this one is the pure quartz, I believe. Ack. Why didn't those stack? That's okay. Let's look for inscriber. We have. Is it there four? Oh, yes, there are four. Name press. What does that do? Okay. Inscriber calculation press. You can. Casting table molten lead. That doesn't. Oh, wait. Is that the one we're supposed to make? We're supposed to make a calculation press. This just says the casting table, does not say anything about sifting. That's weird. Why? Why would they tell you to use the sifter? So I wonder if I could take, what's the difference if you use the calculation, or if you use this, that only takes like 1 bar of lead. So that would be a lot different than sifting a block. So I guess we can do that since we already have a smeltery set up anyway. Let's see. That one was lead. And I think all we need to do is take this guy off because it didn't appear to have anything on the table, just that it's a table. So I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I guess I can turn the automated thing off and just use this one. I swear I got it. Come on, go. Go, lead. Do your stuff. Melt. Awesome. Okay, here goes. And it worked. We have a calculation press. Amazing. And now we need to make an inscriber, which is right here. Isn't there? Oh, there is an advanced inscriber too. I saw that when I looked at the AE2 stuff. But we'll definitely need to look into that, because it just adds like a couple hoppers and processors to it. Because these are pretty hard to work with too. Sticky pistons? What? Oh no! Oh, you know what? Can't you use rubber on sticky pistons? Thought you could before. Let's see. Can you? I got a whole bunch of that stuff because we have quartz dust out the wazoo. Okay, so we need pistons. Do I have everything? Pistons. Yes. That's excellent. 'Cause I don't really have slime balls. I do have a way to get rubber though. So now we have those. And I think it took a crystal there. Yeah, I guess we can just do this. Bloop. Inscriber. Oh, yes. Inscriber. Awesome. Okay. Let's sleep. I had a problem over there at the mob farm to somehow. I don't know if it was a lighting glitch or something, but I had mobs spawn on top. I guess I took the center torch out when I did this, and I thought the edge torches were enough. I guess I could move them in a little bit, and then I won't need this torch here. I just did not light this up. Bad, Debbie, bad. It's okay. It was just a couple skeletons and zombies. No big deal. Okay, so that should keep that well lit up. Yeah, I was really surprised when I looked over there and I was like, what are their mobs doing on top of my mob farm? All right, let's turn this thing in. We get an engineering press and a reward bag. Oh, a greater reward bag. Let's see what is in the bag. That just made me think of something. Whenever I'm playing and I get a bag, my husband is always sitting there going, "Open the bag, open the bag. Let's see what's in the bag." If I don't open it, immediately, he's like, always going, "What's in the bag? Look in the bag." So, nether quartz. That's kind of cool. It's useful. I would definitely use it. Yeah, I have some on me, so I can just leave it there. Oh, yeah. I was hoping for something a little bit less common than that, but okay. Now, this one. Yes, we're getting into the network. Mwahahahaha. Basic network. For a basic network, you will need an ME drive, ME cables, and an ME terminal. The drive holds storage cells, which is where all of your items are stored in digital format. The terminal allows you to access the items inside the cells. The cable provides power. Hook it to a power source and connects the parts. Okay, so we need these. Yeah, let's try to get this done really quickly and then we'll go ahead and call it there. And that's going to get us a 1K storage cell. So we'll have two and a full heart. Oh, a full heart or a reward bag. So we'll probably take the reward bag. Okie dokie. So we're probably going to need to set this guy up here somewhere. I don't think any of these are taking channels yet. I don't really have a way yet. I don't have any smart cables to see what is on there. Okay, so let's get our inscriber press down. Excellent. Actually, can't you just connect it to that? I wonder. Let's get our little wrench. Let's see. Will it? Did that save the energy? I can't tell. No, because it says 0 AE now. Okay. It still says 0 AE on there, so I guess it didn't. It won't work. I thought it was when I saw that update like that, but this one still says 0 AE, so I don't know. Oh my goodness. Okay, so let's see. We need drive 1K. One K storage. What is that? 1K ME storage. Okay, well that's good enough. And what was it? Terminal? Terminal. I think it was just the plain one. Okay, so what do we need here? Oh, we're gonna have to make some engineering processors, but in order to do this, we're gonna need the silicon press, and we don't have that. Okay. Do we need that for anything else? We needed the ME terminal. Yeah, because we need a logic processor for this and these, I believe. Yes. And this also takes the gold ones as well. So we'll also need the logic press. So we need to go ahead and just get our press. Our press. sensors, which we'll do down here. Let's have a look at NEI. Oh. Okay, an arcane crafting terminal. That sounds pretty cool. All right, let's look at this. We need a logic press. And that's gonna take molten copper. So let's throw a piece of copper in there. Boop. There it is. Okay, that's for the logic press. And now, excuse me, we're going to need the silicon press. And that's going to take molten nickel. Bloop. How's that going over there? Almost. It's almost there. Get a little sip. And done. Okay. Now we'll run over here. Boom. And we have our inscriber logic press. Excellent, excellent, excellent. That is awesome. Here we go. Okay, one of the quirks of this inscriber press is that you can only put like one thing in at a time, which is highly annoying. Very, very highly annoying. At least I find it highly annoying. There are ways that you know, once you get the AE2 network set up, you can have the system auto-craft it and stuff, so that's not a big deal. But to begin with, yes, it is a little bit annoying. So now we need some silicon. And that you just get by cooking any of the dust, like quartz dust or nether quartz dust. Believe you could even use flux crystals dust, but I'm not sure. Let's look and see what our options are. I'm probably going to just use the quartz. Quartz, nether quartz. Yeah, okay. So we don't have very much nether quartz, so I'm definitely just going to do up a bunch of this Certus quartz dust. And let's see, we need several. One. Two, three, four, five, six, maybe. Maybe more, but that'll do for now. Okay. Now we can go. I have no idea what I'm doing. This is a new placement, so it has me sort of not operating at peak efficiency. There we go. Now the thing is, it does stack in here if it stacks. So that's kind of cool. You can just keep, that's how you can somewhat semi-automate it with a few hoppers. Make up and just load a bunch of silicon into it and have it make up a bunch of silicon at once, which I'll probably do until I get the advanced one. Okay, so we have a few of these, and I know we're gonna need some diamonds. See, this is why we need the AE network up, so we don't have to run all over the place. Actually, let me just down here. Bloop. Cheating. I think we need two of these and then the rest are gold. Ooh, we might need to grab some gold while we're down here. Here we go! Yeah, I didn't take the stairs on that. Okay, so we need the engineering press. Ooh, we're definitely gonna need to upgrade this thing. But, yes. Okay, there's our two. I think... Oh, I was like, why won't that go in there? Oh my goodness. It's the wrong materials, that's why. Yeah, this is the annoying part of of the E2, is just getting it set up, but it's definitely worth it. In the end, it definitely pays off having a little bit of patience. Sometimes I like kicking this thing, but, you know. Okay, so we have some redstone. We can throw that in there and then throw our press in there. And if you shift click on those, they go right in there. Which is kind of cool. Okay, there's our two. I guess if I put those together, that would be a little bit more efficient. Awesome. Awesome. AE. AE Joe. This is like the best parts of modded, because having a storage system that you can just access all your stuff all in one spot, and it just makes life so much easier in Minecraft. Okay, so we got our processors and stuff. And I do believe I have some glass cable. We're gonna need a crafting bench here. Here we go. Emmy Drive. Bam! Yes. We're getting a little bit full here. Okay, Emmy Terminal. We have one of those. What about this? Illuminated panel. We don't have the glowstone. Should have everything else. Let's just grab. Oh, wait, we don't. I do get glowstone over there, but I also get glowstone here. Boop, boop. Don't use that very much, or I would have just grabbed a stack. Alright, let's get this done. Okie dokie. Doop, doop. Hey, come on. Oh no, I need some more of this glass, I think. Yes. Awesome. Okay, next step. We need these formation core and annihilation core. Let's use the quartz one. We just need one of those. Formation. We don't want it to use a charged one. Oh man. Okay. It's Certus Quartz, I think. One of those and one of those. I think it didn't do it because it was up here. Not sure. Oh man, I'm getting so full. Okay. There we go. ME terminal. Oh no, I am. Why wouldn't that go in? Okay, now we need this. It used the pure one. Let's keep that out because I know that you have to have those for the calculation presses. There we go. And we have to put it in one of these. What am I missing? The glass, maybe again. Yes. And shazam! Better than chest. Oh, yeah. We're gonna take that bag. Do I even have the room for it? No. I do not absolutely have any room at all. Okay, let's go up here and we'll set our drive down. I wonder if I need cable under that. Does that get. Okay, that's getting power, I think. I think you need that and an ME terminal. Okay, it is getting power. We can put stuff in it. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh, this is so awesome. I do want to make it smaller like that. Yes. I like this one better. Okay. Yes. We have AE. So let's get the bag. There we go. That gets us another drive. We can put in there. And a good reward bag full of good goodies. Fermented spider eyes and plain spider eyes. These bags do just do not like me. I tell you, they just do not like me. I guess we can put these spider eyes over here. So yes, definitely a successful day. How did you? Oh no, when I moved the torches back, it made these little ledges. Ah. I just can't win, can I? Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and call it here. And we will see you next time for another action pa- Oh goodness, there's another witch over there. Look at that. Why are you stopping it? Okay, I think I got everything. Yes, another action-packed adventure coming your way soon. Thank you for watching, and bye-bye.